Yes, I was nervous. You see, this just wasn't any school. Rings would forever change my view of school, the people of my race, and my own self-esteem. I was no longer just a student. I had become a Rings Viking.
At a time when the U.S. was dominated by racial segregation.
But the only reason Rings was built was because the schools were segregated and the whites at Revolt, the school board did not want us at Revolt.
Before no child left behind.
Move all the blacks over here, bring all the whites over there. And now you got them where, first of all, they aren't accustomed to the culture of our students.
Came the birthing of School 165.
It was the new school. And we were school number 165.
Dr. Robinson built a school for black students. He hired the best black faculty he could find. He built support for the school in the black community.
The first day at Rains for me was absorbing the environment. Here we were at a brand new school, a brand new physical plant. And although the other students had been there for maybe one semester, it was everything was brand new.
With the $2 million building now in place, the school board needed someone to lead the charge.
Everywhere, there is no person that has come into my life, educational-wise and the like, who could surpass, has surpassed Dr. Andrew A. Robinson. He's a real person.
He had a great way with people. Dr. Robinson could make you, he could make you think you were great. You were bigger than big.
Right.
And you could do anything. He was just that way. Mm. He had that kind of personality.
School 165 had now become Rains High School and quickly became the talk of the town as they excelled in both sports and academics. Dr. Robinson had started a tradition of pride and confidence that would transcend beyond his generation. By telling a group of students who were used to being last that they were now Ichiban, meaning number one. And that was the beginning of the Viking pride.
Follow in the tradition of Vincent Robinson, Ronald Lewis. Those were the guys that preceded me. Mm-hmm. Kenny Duffy, were those guys that followed, preceded me at Rains. And so, it was no doubt from the moment that, I was probably 10 that I was going to Rains High School.
Wow.
Just remember, going to the games as a little boy and just seeing how much of the camaraderie and everything that was going on, and it's something that I wanted to do and be a part of.
When that Rains, the guys, we kind of envied the guys that Rains over at Reebok because they dressed polo, tucked in, Eastlands, and took pride about how we look and how we stood up for each other.
It was my second year teaching here at Rains, where I became aware of the fact that some of the other schools in Duval County, they were having mock weddings, and so we decided that we would have one as well. Of course, it started on a very low budget at that particular time. I can remember the girls just wearing dresses that they had already in their wardrobe, and we got some tuxedos that were really, outdated, but we did have our mock wedding. And as time progressed, we got very sophisticated.
But even Rains High School at its peak would not be able to escape the gradual decline of America's educational system.
We were raised by our mother and our father, who were both living in the house, who are in their 80s, still together.
In the same house.
In the same house.
Taking care of each other.
Taking care of each other. But today, families are not like that.
Family.
taken all of the cream out of the community. I mean, the students that were, you know, were dying to go to Reigns were no longer wanting to go to Reigns. And that's just it's a shame to, you know, see that it's gotten to this point, but for the community to, and the students to feel like they've lost that connection, and how to get it back is a mystery.
I just can't see them taking away all of those kids in that area of education. Where do you send them at?
We've heard all the statistics and shortcomings. Now experience the history as told by the students and teachers who lived it, and follow one man on his quest to uncover the rich heritage behind a school that produced some of the country's finest. Remember the beginning. Remember the culture. We remember.